Welcome to this Caaspp video tutorial, Setting Up a Test Session. By the end of this tutorial, test administrators will understand the process for launching, monitoring, and ending a test session for a Smarter Balanced Summative Assessment. The process demonstrated in this tutorial is similar to that used to administer the Smarter Balanced Interim Assessments or any other Caaspp assessment that require administration through the test administrator interface. This process assumes, too, that well in advance of administering a test, the test administrator has verified all of the students' names, grades, SSID numbers, test settings, and other demographic information in TOMS to ensure everything is correct and up to date. Now let's begin by visiting the Caaspp portal at caaspp.org and select the Test Administrator Interface for All Online Tests button. Log on to the Test Administrator interface using a standard web browser and your current year TOMS or Caaspp logon access. If you are not successful in logging on to the Test Administrator interface, contact your test site coordinator or LEA Caaspp coordinator for assistance. Once logged on to the Test Administrator interface, the first step is for the test administrator to select the correct test. In this video tutorial, we will be selecting a Smarter Balanced Summative Test. More specifically, we will be selecting a Grade 8 English Language Arts Computer Adaptive Test. Expand the box that says Smarter Balanced Summative Assessments by clicking on the plus sign icon. Continue clicking on the plus sign icons to expand the options until you see the exact grade and the name of the test you are administering to your students. Once you see the correct test, click the checkbox next to the name of that test. In this example, the Grade 8 ELA CAT test is selected by clicking the box next to the name of the test. In this same manner, by clicking on the plus sign icons and expanding the options, additional tests can be selected if more than one test is being administered in a test session. To support the test selection process, color is used to help test administrators distinguish the different types of tests available in the test administrator interface. For example, green is used to code the Smarter Balanced Interim Assessments, red the Smarter Balanced Summative Assessments, indigo the California Alternate Assessments, and so forth. Please note that at a given point in time, all tests may not be available in the test administrator interface. Therefore, you will not always see all of these colors available for test selection. A test only becomes available in the test administrator interface when the test administration window is open for that test. Once the test selections are made, the test administrator then selects the Start Operational Session button to start the session and generate a session ID. The session ID displays on the upper right-hand corner of the test session page. The test administrator writes or displays the session ID clearly with letters, numbers, and dashes, exactly as shown in a place where all students in the test session can see it. If the test administrator adds another test to the session after the test session is underway, a confirmation message box will confirm the addition of test to a session. Students then log on through the secure browser using their first name, SSID number, and the session ID. It is very important to ensure students with the same first name in your class receive the correct SSID number to log on. After logging on, students will see the Is This You screen. Students should select Yes to continue, assuming the information on the screen is correct. As students log on to take the test, only those tests that have been selected by the test administrator and match the grade of the student will appear on the student screen. All others will be grayed out. Upon selecting a test, students wait for the test administrator approval. As students select test, the test administrator can see approvals populate in the approvals queue of the test administrator interface. The test administrator verifies that the students have selected the appropriate test and, as needed, reviews the student's test settings by selecting the View button to the far right of each student's name. Students' test settings, including accessibility supports, which are set and defined in TOMS, will be present in the test administrator interface for all online assessments. From the individual student test settings screen, the test administrator can select Set to confirm the current test settings and return to the list of students for approval. Or the test administrator can select Set and Approve to establish the existing settings and approve the student for testing. If a student's test settings are incorrect, test administrators should deny the student, contact the LEA CASP coordinator or test site coordinator to correct the test settings in TOMS and plan to test the student at a later time. For summative assessments, test settings cannot be changed in the test administrator interface. For interim assessments, they can be changed, although such changes do not get recorded back to TOMS. Only LEA CASP coordinator or test site coordinators can change test settings in TOMS. In order to avoid taking too much time to review each student's test settings or having to reschedule a student for testing because settings need to be changed, students' test settings should be reviewed and finalized in TOMS, well in advance of administering a test. Upon reviewing test settings, as needed, the test administrator approves students to test. He or she selects Approve to approve a specific student for testing, or selects Approve All Students to approve all students for testing. Ensure all student test assignments and test settings are correct before approving all students. After the test administrator has approved a student for testing, the student verifies the test information and settings on their screen and selects Yes, Start My Test. If a student has a text-to-speech accommodation or is taking a test with ELA listening questions, he or she will do an audio and video check using the headphones. Finally, students will see the test instructions and help page before they begin testing. Students then select Begin Test Now to begin testing. Test administrators should monitor student progress as they are testing from the students in your operational test session area on the test administrator interface, and by walking around and checking that the desired test conditions are being maintained. Test administrators may pause an individual student's test if needed. Students can also pause the test from their testing screens. Pause rules may vary depending on the online test, so test administrators should become familiar with the pause rules in advance for the test being administered. In the case of Smarter Balanced Summative Testing, for example, if a CAT is paused for less than 20 minutes, the student logs in again using the same session ID to resume testing and is presented with the test question he or she was working on when the test was paused. Everything is preserved, including highlighted text and student comments entered on a notepad. All questions, even those that have been answered, remain available for the student to change. If a CAT is paused for more than 20 minutes, the student logs in again using the same session ID to resume testing. However, now the student is presented with a test page containing the test question he or she was last working on. If the page contains one or more unanswered questions, or presented with the next test page, if all questions on the previous test page registered a response. The student is not permitted to review or change any test questions on previous pages. This includes partially answered constructive response items in English language arts. For example, a single test page has items 4 through 10. A student answers items 4 through 7 and pauses the test for more than 20 minutes. When the student resumes testing, he or she can change answers to items 4 through 10, but cannot return to items 1 through 3 on an earlier page. If a test page contains items 9 through 11 and a student answers all of the items before pausing the test for more than 20 minutes, when the student resumes testing, he or she will begin on item 12 and cannot return to items 1 through 11. There are no pause rules for the performance task. Just note that the ELA performance tasks are divided into two parts. After a student completes the first part, he or she cannot return to it. For all online tests, if there is a technical issue such as a power outage or network failure, students will be logged out and the test will automatically be paused. And as a security measure, students are automatically logged out of a test after 30 minutes of inactivity. Activity means selecting an answer or using a navigation option in the test, such as next or back. Moving the mouse or selecting an empty space on the screen is not considered activity. To end the test session, the test administrator selects the Stop Session button in the upper right corner of the test administrator interface. This will stop the test for all students in the session. Students should be warned at least 10 minutes in advance that a test session is coming to an end. An important box will appear, requesting verification to end the session and log students out. Select OK to end and log out of the test session. Note that logging off from the test administrator interface will also stop a session. In addition to viewing this tutorial, before launching an online test, you are encouraged to review the user guide or test administration manual for the test you will be administering to make sure you are familiar with the details regarding the administration procedures, students' test settings, pause rules, and how to end the test, as there are differences depending on the test to be administered. Thanks for watching this Caaspp video tutorial. For more information, visit the Caaspp portal at www.caaspp.org.